explorers, human beings, you and I, are all born with this inherent curiosity to explore the unknown. From the first steps of a newborn child to our first steps on the moon, there's something about our desire to discover new frontiers and new horizons that not only defines us as a species, but also makes us successful. You might think of exploration in a classical sense, of some person from some other country finding new land and claiming it with a flag. Well, if that's the case, then you might be thinking that our generation, people alive today, have arrived on the scene too late to explore the Earth, but still too early to explore the universe. But I would argue that we live in a brave new world of exploration, one made possible by every human being alive today. Ever since I was a child, I had a deep passion for space exploration. I wanted to go on adventures to the stars. My dad raised me on Star Wars and Star Trek, and when I was 15, I finished Halo. There was something about exploration that captivated me. And even as a child, I had this gut feeling that a large part of the human future would take place in outer space. So let's explore together, you and me. From our humble beginnings here on planet Earth to the edge of the unknown. Here we are. We'll take one round around the Earth, then leave the planet. We'll go to the moon, the farthest any human has ever traveled. Leave the solar system, there goes all the planets. Now the sun, just another point of light like all the other stars we see at night. We'll go to the Oort cloud, a ball of rock and ice. It's where comets come from. Farther out, that's our local stellar neighborhood, a group of the 20 stars closest to us, Alpha Centauri, Proxima Centauri, Barnard star, the list goes on and on. Further out from there, you get the Orion arm of the Milky Way galaxy. Every point of light in this picture is a star that may have a planet that harbors life. It's very sobering to think about. Go even further out, you see the Milky Way in its entirety, 100,000 light years across. Light. Traveling at the speed of light takes you 100,000 years to go from one end to the other end. The Milky Way and Andromeda are local group of galaxies. Every point of light in this picture is no longer a star, but an entire galaxy with billions and billions of stars. There's a little bit more stuff here, and we're at the edge of the observable universe. At this point, light hasn't had a chance to reach us yet, so we can't really see what's beyond that curtain of the unknown. Charming, isn't it? It's a very beautiful picture, one that has taken human beings thousands of years to piece together. I didn't need a spaceship to take you on this journey, and you didn't even have to leave the comfort of your own chair. But looking back on all of that, how does it make you feel? Do you feel small, or do you feel involved? Do you really feel like an explorer, or were you simply watching a video? I just took you on a journey from our own little backyard here on Earth to the backyard of infinity. But some infinities are larger than others, as author John Green is so fond of saying. But what made this journey possible was the infinities of human thoughts and ideas. And as nebulous and mysterious as it may sound, I think that is an infinity worth exploring for all of us. That's the age of exploration that we live in today. We embark on a journey powered by ideas born from the limitless potential of the human mind. The frontier is everywhere, and it is everything that we can think of and imagine. Whether it's art or humanities, science or philosophy, music or history, whatever form of expression, we are all explorers, and the world needs explorers. So join me as we explore the world of ideas worth spreading at TEDxMMU on the 15th of January, 2015. My name is Sanaterra92, scientist, explorer, wanderer, and I'll see you next time.